presentation on the topic of importance of LinkedIn for MBAs. First, let's talk about the abstract. So we all have heard the phrase that is LinkedIn is the new Facebook. Both are social media sites. Facebook is generally for the personal connections, like for the informal connections where you can see what's going on in their personal lives. While LinkedIn is somewhat a professional form of Facebook, in which we connect with people professionally. We tend to know about what's going in their career and their profession, and that's what we'll be discussing further in the presentation. As I'm a management student, LinkedIn is very, very important and it plays a crucial role in my career setting. So that we'll be discussing further. So for the table of contents, first we'll go through the introduction, like what is LinkedIn. Second, we'll discuss its importance. Why has that become so important lately? Third, we'll talk about the benefits, like why should a management student join LinkedIn? And not only about management student, but any graduate or any professional should join LinkedIn. What benefits are there? Next, what is the future of LinkedIn? What changes are going to add in LinkedIn? And how can we benefit from LinkedIn in future? Fifth one would be the conclusion, like what do I wish to deliver from this presentation? And if any questions from your side. Now let's start with the introduction. So LinkedIn was launched on May 5, 2003. It is an American business and employment orientation service. It's a form of social media in which we may connect with people in terms of, we may search them by their company name, by their designation, or by their location. Or even if we know them personally, also LinkedIn shows you some connections in which we have some mutual friends or as per our interests. So this is why it is basically for the professional networking. At present, it has more than 722 million registers and million members are registered, and it is currently working in more than 200 countries. The founder of LinkedIn, Mr. Reid Hoffman, had said that the fastest way to change yourself is to hang out with people who are already the way you want to be. Because the kind of people we hang out with, it affects a lot on our personality. So if I'll be hanging out with people who are successful and with, so I would be able to bring that change in myself. I'd be able to search for business opportunities. I'll be able to grow myself in that field. When we are a management student, we need to look for career opportunities because we need to grow, we need to learn. We are not experienced, we are fresher, and there is yet to learn. So LinkedIn gives you a platform to connect with those people who have that experience, who have that knowledge, so that you can connect with them and you can learn with them. You can learn from their experiences as well. So this is what the founder of LinkedIn has to say. Now let's moving on to the next topic, that is the importance of LinkedIn and why it has become so important lately. So to start with, LinkedIn is not only the one social media platform. There are many social media platforms that are there right now. Some of the top we'll be discussing, Facebook, as I told in the abstract, that LinkedIn is called the new Facebook for professionals. So Facebook is the ultimate one through which people connect LinkedIn with. It is the largest social networking site where we connect with friends, relatives, peers. Generally, we share images and videos of our personal lives, like a personal family trip or a trip with friends or something which could be fun to promote our personal life on social media. Next comes Instagram. It has now been acquired by Mark Zuckerberg, who is the founder of Facebook. Instagram is one of the most popular, excellent photo and video app, which is very, very popular among the youngsters, basically. The elder generation is not very fond of Instagram. Instagram gives you the permission to keep your account private or public. Coming to the Snapchat, this messaging app has a different sort of craze. First, because you can maintain streaks with your friends, which allows you to use the app regularly, which is also one of its USP. And second, it's self-destruction mode for sending the messages and videos. That is, once you have read the message, it would delete itself. You don't have to worry to delete the chats or something. The last is YouTube, which is a video sharing app where you can connect with users who have created videos, or you can create videos of your own to share knowledge with the others. Now, LinkedIn basically is a mix of all these four top apps. From Facebook, you can connect with your peers, your family, your members, or any professional you want to connect with. As on Instagram, you can keep your LinkedIn sort of public, sort of private. It gives you some options, what all information you want to share publicly and what all information you want to share with your connections. For Snapchat, it is very famous among youngsters because it helps you in building career. And at this stage of 20s, the major focus is on the career only. And last, YouTube. YouTube is a video service app. Also, LinkedIn allows you to share your videos with your connections and your connections of connections. At present, this number, which is 722 million plus, there are professionals to connect with our career. Sir, am I audible? Hello?
Yes, you are clearly audible. Okay, you can continue.
Sure, sir. So as per the number says, this is 722 million plus professionals to connect with our career, which means that a management student looking career in any of the desired field, may it be finance or marketing or operations or HR or IT, any field, they would get professionals of their field of their interest. And not only in these fields of education, but if you go to the fields of media as well, like maybe go to animation or video editing or photography or something, you would be able to connect professionals of that field as well. So it's not a platform where you can only connect with a certain group of professionals, but it's a platform where you can connect each and every one of your interest. They're just a connection away. Now to talk about the promotional perspective of LinkedIn, we can see the map where it shows how many million plus users are there in every country or every state. And some of the benefits are 94% of people who use LinkedIn use it for B2B marketers. That is from business to business marketing. They use it for content marketing as well as lead generations. The companies earlier known as MLM or now they work on connections where the lead generation is the, as number of leads increase, their revenues increase. So in that kind of organization, they benefit the most from LinkedIn as generating leads is very easier. Now, 40% of the daily users of LinkedIn have seen an increase of by 14% since the end of 2018, that is in the past 2 years. And it is expected to grow more till 2027. Now, 12% advertisements on LinkedIn, it reaches the world population over the age of 13. To use LinkedIn, you should be over the age of 13, that is for US, or any other Western country, you should be at least enrolled in a high school. And if we talk to India, you should be a graduate or at least a 9th or 10th standard student to make the essential use of LinkedIn for your age. So when anyone promotes an advertisement on LinkedIn, it reaches the worldwide, especially the people who are worldwide, including the people age of 13 who have their accounts on LinkedIn and they use it on a regular basis. Now, talking from the growth perspective, as you can see from the graph, LinkedIn has seen a stagnant growth from the year 2012. For the basic important points for this one is 61% of the LinkedIn users are from the age of 25 to 34. As I mentioned earlier, the age of 20s is basically the age for your career setting and majority of the people are focused to set their career in a certain field. So the professionals are also of that age only. They may help you, they may guide you a majority of content. So the crucial age for career setting is there on LinkedIn. So you don't have to worry that there would be a generation gap in understanding or something. The people, the professionals working there are also of your generation decade, we can say. Next is 57% people, the traffic on LinkedIn comes from the mobile traffic. That is, LinkedIn can be used on desktop as well as mobiles, but 57% people use it on mobile, which is a very good way to connect because nowadays mobile has become a necessity for everyone. Like it's always there in our hands. We may be using it for any social media platform, maybe WhatsApp, Facebook, or LinkedIn. So whenever you text, just a message popping on the notification screen, it gives you an opportunity to connect with the people faster. the replies are faster, and so you can able to connect yourself, you may able to grow and learn faster because you don't have to wait for the replies. Next is a 15 times scope for education. LinkedIn has LinkedIn itself has many certificates which can be for which a student can enroll, learn, give the exam and score the certificate. So it gives a 15 times scope for education. Also, LinkedIn suggests you some of the certificates as per your interest, as per your search histories, etc. So it has more content impression and job postings as well. Content impression is that certifications, and for the job postings, the companies and the professionals or the HR, the talent acquisitions team of the organization, they continuously are posting about the internships or the jobs that are available for the company. So we may apply for that as well. Now talking about the organizational aspect, as I told you earlier that there are 722 million plus active users on LinkedIn, out of which 630 million are professionals, which means that there are very few of us who are still students or freshers and are looking for job, and a most majority percentage is there who is already working in the corporate sector. So you don't have to worry that there are not enough people to help you or guide you. There are 630 million out of 722 million people who are ready to help us. Now, some important points for the organizational aspect. There are 30 million plus companies that are listed on LinkedIn, which is a great number because ultimately one student would land up at one job in a particular one company. So having an option of 30 million plus companies is a very, very good number for job seekers. Next is 80% the people from this 630 million are the ones who drive business decisions. By driving business decisions, I mean that they are the people who are at a senior level. Maybe they are a department head or maybe manager head or team leaders or, it may go up to CEOs and the founders as well. So the people who drive business decisions, they know what's going on in the industry and are more aware as compared to a management student. So there's always a very much scope of learning. Also, the target audience by the job can be targeted. Like if a student is targeting marketing or finance, the company can target the student relating to their search, like if they're searching for marketing, the company may target them for marketing as well. So they don't just target for demographics, like they need only a student, a job seeker in a particular state, but they may also target a job seeker who is interested in a particular sector. So that is also one benefit. Especially this benefit is given to the people who are of small cities, which do not have much companies. So, they are not left out. They could be included in the job selection process. Now, next is 59% are the sales professionals, which is the management students who are looking to go into the marketing or the sales field further in their education. They are very, very much beneficial because more than a majority, which is 59% of the people, are sales professionals. As I told you earlier that LinkedIn is very beneficial for MLMs and the company, the organizations that work on lead generations. So this is somewhat connected to that point as well, because lead generations is ultimately the work of the marketing or the sales team. So they are the people who are also very much benefited from the same. Now, next, after the importance, we'll talk about the benefits of joining LinkedIn if you're a student. So first is an acronym, FOMO. FOMO stands for fear of missing out. Now, whenever you're not connected on any of the social media platform, there's constantly a fear that is running that I might miss on the information. Let's talk informally. So they might only miss on the information that their friends have gone to some party, or maybe they went for a trip and you miss that information. You don't know what all hot gossips are going on around. So this could be for the social life. Now, when we talk about the professional life, you may miss upon some industry news. You may miss upon some other factors which you should be knowing related to your field, like maybe some new certifications that your peer group is doing and you don't know about that. So all that fear of missing out is left when you are connected on a professional social network such as LinkedIn. So this is one of the major benefits. Now, before discussing the other benefits, we'll go through the evolution of social media. So ultimately, LinkedIn was found, the first social media app that was found in 2002, followed by Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Tumblr, Insta, and Snapchat. And LinkedIn gained popularity after 2006. that is the time when when Facebook was already popular among people. So this is one of the major reasons why LinkedIn is also known as the Facebook for professionals. Although Facebook came late, but Facebook got its place in people's heart earlier, and LinkedIn followed it later. So this was the evolution why LinkedIn came before Facebook, but is also known by the name of Facebook is something because of this timeline. Next, talking about the important benefit is a platform to connect with professionals. LinkedIn shows you the number of connections. When you have a LinkedIn profile, they show you the number of connections, which shows the exact number until you reach 501. And as soon as you reach 501, it starts showing you 500 plus. Now, even if you have 10 lakh connections, the LinkedIn profile will show you only 500 plus connections are there by this person. So an average person on LinkedIn, a management student who does not use it regularly or is very irregular, use it just weekly or monthly, they have connections less than 500, which is a very average number of connections. And more than 500 connections is very great because you would be connected with many HRs, many finance people and many sales people or many marketing people. So you have a dynamic group of connections there. So it's not only that you're getting information to one related field, but it's like you get information to every field from every of the connection you post. Now, if we think that even 50% of these 500 people are there who post very frequently, then also you will get around 250 articles to read or weekly, or which is a very hefty number, which is very good to keep you aware about what's going on in the industry. So this was one of the factors in which we discussed about the connections. Now, talking about the job offers for an intern for a management student. So they could be looking for an internship or for a full-time offer. Now, full-time offer is given after you have completed your studies, so you don't have to go to college anymore. And you can give your from 9 to 6 or 9 to 5, your whole day to your office. So that is when we call it full-time. So we can approach the HR managers of the companies with our CVs or any company we want to work with or any profile that really infatuates us and we really wish to apply for the job. We can contact the HR's managers and we can share our CV through the LinkedIn itself. And the HRs can also go through your LinkedIn profile because it's a complete profile of what you have done in your career, in your professional career. We may add even internships, your certifications, etc. So sometimes the HR also they do not ask for your CV, but they just ask for your LinkedIn profile so that they could just go through what have you done, what have you shared, which post you have liked, etc. So they could just get a whole overview of what sort of a person you are, and they may decide upon which would you be suitable or not. So this is one of the major way you can connect with the HRs. Internships is basically a life project that goes on that a student can carry on with his or her management studies. So with this, we can work with the top companies or with startups or any of the companies that provide you job in your desired field. It's basically to gain experience, to have some hands-on experience on in practical exposure towards the organization, towards the corporate, we can say. So this is basically for experience and to learn what would be working after a management, what would be the role, and what could we expect from the corporate. So this is all we learned from the internship. So LinkedIn provides you the opportunity to apply for internships as well as for full-time job opportunities. Now next, we are always aware of what's going into the industry. Now let's see, as I told you that we can post something, we can share videos and photos. So I've placed three examples here in which one person has posted that they have completed the certificate in cost analysis. So for example, any student, any finance student who is willing to work in the same field, he or she might find it relevant to pursue. And if they do so, they would be aware that, okay, if I wish to go to this field, I can pursue this certificate. So not only for one, but for many such posts, you get to know what certifications are required, what your peer group is doing into this field of industry. Next is second example I've taken is the girl has completed her education and she's looking for a part-time job in an FMCG company. So this is although a personal post, but you may feel that, okay, there are vacancies in an FMCG company. So if it's sometimes people share that they are in a quick search of a job or something. So you may recommend them the same thing as you would be knowing that there's a vacancy in the FMCG company. Now, next, there's an old man who's saying that I've been working with this organization for X years and he's sharing an experience. So it might happen that you sometimes do not know much about the company, but when people of older age who have been working with the company share their experiences, you can judge the company. You sometimes feel that, okay, the working environment is good. Maybe I can try to apply there, or maybe I can go to that company to work for. So this is not only adds points to the organization, but it also gives you information about what working culture different organizations are providing to different kind of people. Now, next is we can build a personal brand of ourselves. Okay, so I'm not saying that this is a very easy job. This is a very complicated and a very hassled job. As you can see in the picture, the girl is very, very confused, like what to add and what to not. So there are some pointers which may be added, like we can add our achievements. Achievements can be any certifications that we have done or any awards that we have won for in a particular field that could be added. We can add a job experience to show that we know we have worked in the particular field and we have the experience of working there. So if you are applying into some other company in the relevant field, that could be an added benefit for you because you have already added in your LinkedIn that you have this experience and you know how the work is done. So company would also not have to waste much time on your training, etc. So this could be added. Next is topics which interest us. Like if I am interested in finance, I would add that to my LinkedIn. I'm a finance student. So that the companies who are looking for jobs like lead generation or for talent acquisition positions, they would not follow me, they would not add me, or they would not send me their job descriptions because I've clearly written that I'm a finance student, so I'll be interested only in the field of finance. So these topics are very essential to add because there are n number of fields, and in this digital world, you can go to any of the field you wish to go to. Also, sometimes people do certifications of other fields just for the sake of knowledge. So there's a misconception that if you have added your certifications, you don't need to add the fields that interest you. I find it wrong because certifications can be done in any field of your interest. It might be a temporary infatuation toward that field, but after studying, you feel that you don't really like it. But you can add it as a certificate. So topics of interest are basically your hobbies or your passions, which you'll share in a professional way. So I think this could be covered in this. Next is advertising our skills, which can be, let's say a person is a blogger. So they can definitely share some of their posts on LinkedIn so that the people, their connections can go through and they can judge that, is this good or is that bad? Or if he's a blogger, they would know, okay, yes, she writes. But if the person doesn't post anything or they're not connected to their connections in any way, and they're just writing that I'm a blogger, I write very frequently, they would not believe because you have not given anything for them to believe. So one should advertise their skills. Next is building credibility. So building credibility is reliability on your LinkedIn profile. What have you written in your CV or what have you told about yourself that should be reflected from your profile, from the work you have done, from the certifications you have gained. So this trust should be there in what you're speaking and what you're reflecting. So that is basically about building the credibility. And next is increase your visibility. Increasing visibility is go for connections. Generally, I've seen profiles with people who are 100 and 150 connections or only 100, 200 connections. So it should not be like that. Go and connect with people. It gives you a platform to learn. Increase your visibility. Comment on people's posts. That gives the HRs to know you. So that is the way you build your personal brand. So these were some of the pointers you may add new. Next is be found on Google. Now, when you are on LinkedIn, you have built your personal profile. You're a personal brand on LinkedIn. So whenever you search your name on Google, your LinkedIn profile will be the first one that pops out on Google. Something relating to your topic. And when you click on that hashtag, it builds up a community sort of group where you may talk with all the people, you may have discussions with the people who have used the same hashtag. Now, sometimes people use extra hashtags to get connections, but you may connect with like-minded people when you're using hashtags. So this is one of the major benefit of LinkedIn, that you may connect, let's say I'm a finance student. I did a certification in cost analysis or budget analysis. Now, if I'm using hashtags such as hashtag finance or hashtag cost or hashtag budget, and now or hashtag cost analysis, where I click on cost analysis and I go to that community, I can see many other posts and many other posts of different people of across the globe. It's not like of a certain location, but they're from across the globe who have done certifications in those field or in a field that might be related to cost analysis. So sometimes you gain knowledge. I might have missed a few points which I didn't know that.